Dr. Wilkerson has crossed tropical rivers such as the Tecolutla countless times with teams of students and assistants. Their multidisciplinary fieldwork is analyzed at Wilkerson's home base in Veracruz, the research center of the Institute for Cultural Ecology of the Tropics. Dr. Wilkerson planned to visit a remote mountain town hidden in the eastern Sierra Madre. Here, the communities that cling to the high peaks celebrate their tenacious hold on life by gathering to perform centuries-old ritual dances and recite stories handed down for generations. In the mountains, many small streams empty into only a few rivers with a sharp gradient. During a major storm, this funnel effect can be deadly.
Thank you. I put life vests on everybody and shouted, leave this on and you might survive. Take it off and it's your ticket to heaven. Seven buildings were lost, one of which might be salvaged to some degree in the future. The others were gone right down to the foundations.
Hoping to recover more documents, Dr. Wilkerson offered him a gratuity. His investment paid off handsomely.
Thank you.
We found at a distance of over 10 kilometers from the research center on the beach south of here, we found lots of books from the library. We found some field equipment. We found additionally a series of materials, not the microscopes, but other types of materials from the lab.
Dr. Wilkerson's expedition to the scar in 1999 revealed some of the answers he had sought so long. After the storm reopened the river's old mouth, tin roof, the research station's workers continued to conserve as many books and documents as possible. Many were lost or destroyed by the fury of the waters, but some managed to make it back, often in appalling conditions. There is a reason for such painstaking work. Many of the rare books, scientific manuscripts, maps, documents, and historical interviews hold surprising data from the last 500 years in tropical Mexico, offering unique perspectives on weather conditions from Aztec times through the colonial period to the present day.
Thank you.
There are moments in time, represented by these white strips, when there were mega floods. And generally, in those particular points, there is an acceleration of change.
In spite of floods and the ruggedness of the terrain, Dr. Wilkerson perseveres. Inspired by the answers still to be found about the origins and decline of Mesoamerican civilizations. We're also seeing changes of sphere of influence. Certain towns and cities which were dominant economically in the greater region prior to the flood are changing their position. Thank you.
here in the Miracle Workshop is where it all comes together. It's the first step of where we take things to the path of conservation and back to being utilized by everybody.
Today, at the Research Center, one-third of the original library have been conserved, the books carefully bound and cataloged. They cover many topics, but climate behavior is a priority. Dr. Wilkerson thinks that climate models can be tested by examining centuries of archaeological, anthropological, and environmental evidence.
The evidence is absolute. There is virtually no reason to believe that they will not occur. The great difference is now we begin to have an idea that they do exist and what sorts of impact they have. So it behooves us to be better prepared. That's the great challenge for the future. It's not whether or not they will occur. They will occur.
The Veracruz government has approved assistance to help the center recover from the 1999 flood, but still more remains to be done to revitalize the research programs and rebuild. The books, the drawings, the botanical specimens, statistics, and the archaeological artifacts.
Yeah.